Hello friends, I welcome you to EBG Pathshala. My name is Dr. Amit Katoch and I am working as Assistant Professor in University Institute of Hotel and Tourism Management of Punjab University. Dear students, I would be taking module titled Baggage Handling and Procedures under the paper Aviation Industry, Ticketing and Frontier Formalities. At the end of the module, the learners will be able to know about the baggage handling systems, distinguish the baggage and its types, and the handling procedures, about the baggage security and the mishandled baggage. Firstly, start with a brief introduction. Whenever we are planning for a new passenger terminal, it is exceptionally vital to design a baggage handling system, that is BHS, that will necessarily meet the requirements of the terminal and its passengers. That's why whenever we are planning for baggage handling systems, the two important aspects to be considered are the size and the operation of the airport terminals, as they greatly impact the choice of specific design components to create an efficient and proper baggage handling system for the novel terminal. Other aspects which influence the type of baggage handling system, the space and necessity of the air terminal, the budget kept by the owner of the airport, the type of aircraft, the fleet of the airlines, and the function standards of the airlines. All these factors assist the airport designer, planner, and baggage handling system planner or designer to decide the finest design for the air terminal. Now I will discuss about the baggage handling systems. A baggage handling system primarily consists of various areas that aid various roles, comprising inputs of baggage, screening area, makeup area, and claim area. Furthermore, the support areas for baggage handling system, all necessary, which contains space used for motor control rooms, programmable logic controller vaults, and supplementary non-conveyor components of baggage handling system. And the support areas of the BHS may vary greatly depending on the air terminal cost, design and functions. The input areas to insert baggage into the baggage handling system are ticket counter areas, baggage check-in area and any other conveyor lines. A programmed or electronic inline baggage screening systems, which are widely used in the air terminals, is known as the screening area. These programmed baggage screening systems comprises explosive detection systems, EDS units, which consists of one or more matrices. The BHS also has a makeup area that is designated piers, berths or makeup devices for heaping the luggage onto the related flight. In case the makeup area is without sortation, the luggage is sorted manually. The claim area comprises of a flat, plate or slope and baggage delivery and various configurations of oversized baggage delivery. Depending upon the baggage, the passengers are divided into six prominent categories: international originating passengers, domestic originating passengers, international destination passengers, domestic destination passengers, international transfer passengers, domestic transfer passengers. All the volume of the passenger categories decide the type and size of baggage handling systems and the various phases required for their planning. In absence of any accumulated data of baggage carried, it is advocated that 1.25 to 2 bags are carried by international passengers, while 1 to 1.25 bags are carried by domestic passengers. And surely the originating passengers' arrival summary pooled together with a flight schedule helps to calculate the baggage volumes of the output travel in a day. This in turn can help to size the input and checked baggage screening and requirement of baggage makeup systems. And the same goes with the pattern of arriving flights, where the baggage volumes, arriving passengers pooled together with flight schedule help in estimating the requirements for inbound baggage handling and baggage claim area. The space and structure of the air terminal decide the corporal arrangement of departures, arrivals, and baggage makeup facilities. If the air terminal is a multi-storied building, then arrival and departure locations can be present on the different levels. On the contrary, if the terminal is a single level facility, then in that case, the facilities for arrival and departure can be present or are to be present on the same level. Generally, the large and multi-storied structures have departure levels above the arrival levels, but each service area for traveler should give best service or excellent level of service. During the peak seasons, retractable walls can be designed in the claim areas to provide excellent services to the travelers and at the same time give excellent level of service to everyone. Hence, airport owners should also take into account the budget of BHS, keeping in mind the requirement of the arrival and departure services. The outbound baggage have 5 types of inputs, that is staffed check-in counters, self-service check-in kiosks, backdrop counters, self-tagging stations, and curbside check-ins. The baggage flows which need to be considered are of 9 types, that is domestic check-in comprising of all levels of services LOS provided within the same area, that is first class, business and coach class check-in. International check-in is present where the flow of international travelers is huge, and of course the terminal is bestowed to check-in facilities of international traffic. If the domestic and international is catered at the same terminal, then it can use the same conveyor belt until there are no scheduled international departures. Remote check-in. In case the airport terminal has high flows of family vacationers or travelers going for business conference or vacations, in that case, for check-in and transfer of luggage, there are appropriate secured vendors, though for suitable baggage screening proceeding to the departure. International recheck may be present in case the international domestic passengers are going via domestic flights. Odd-sized check-in. In case the baggage of the international or domestic travelers is large or of odd size, in that case, the operation cannot be performed by normal conveyor belt and would require an odd-sized belt system or handled manually. Group check-in. These check-in counters are present at vacation destinations and have the belt which nourishes outbound baggage system. Transfer baggage. In the main hub destinations, huge capacities of baggage transfer is not possible unless there are separate load belts which feed the outbound baggage system, which is further connected to automated or manual sortation systems. Early bag storage systems, that is EBSS, are used in some facilities when huge amount of transfer bags arrive prior than flight departure. These systems are separate than the outbound baggage systems and feed the baggage handling systems for sortation and delivery. a dedicated transfer of load belt or an alteration from the outbound sortation system may facilitate the early originating bags. Special handling items such as pets, firearms, sports gears, bikes, wheelchairs, medical instruments are non-conveyable in nature and require specialized procedures for handling and delivery. Now I would discuss about the baggage sortation systems. They are used in the sorting of baggage and luggage. They are broadly of four types. Number one, centralized sortation, that is localized to terminal. It collects all the baggage, then initiating and transferring to one location and further transferring luggage to sortation system. These systems use automated tag readers, that is ATRs, for automated scanning and universal encoding consoles, that is UECs, for manual sortation in case the automated scan fails. Second is decentralized sortation, that is localized to gates. They sort bag at two or more locations and actual sortation performed adjacent to the individual airplane. Number three, common use sortation system. It combines all of the bags of all the airlines into a common sortation and delivery system. These sort the bags by carrier destination. Fourth, manual sortation. Do not use automated tag readers, that is ATRs, and universal encoding consoles, that is UECs. The baggage sorting occurs manually by using UEC, that is manual encode stations, in the baggage makeup area. In order to do appropriate operation of the baggage sortation, the following elements are important, such as driver assile, drive through, right of way and circulation, baggage cart staging, building column spacing, maintenance and bag jam clearing access, BHS control room, human machine interface graphics, motor control panel locations, programmable logic controller vaults, BHS maintenance room, BHS spare parts room, BHS remote monitoring locations. The two main types of mechanical baggage claim areas are flat plate units comprising the configuration as LT or U. Bags are loaded on the secured non-public side, then pass through the wall and are claimed by passengers, and sloped bed units can be present anywhere and the feed conveyors are able to reach unit from above or below. The odd-sized baggage is moved in three ways, that is oversized belt, which is 45 to 65 inches broad, oversized slide, that is 6 to 10 feet in width, and the manual laydown. Now I will discuss about the baggage types and their handling procedures. Baggage or luggage comprises bags or the materials, suitcases, hand baggage, containers, etc., which are carried by the travelers during their journey or transits. The word baggage has been derived from the French word baggage or from bagues, which means tie up or bundles. The baggage broadly comes in three categories: cabin baggage, checked baggage, and the special baggage. Firstly, discuss about cabin baggage or the hand baggage. The cabin baggage is baggage that is carried and can be stored in the cabin and is in full control and custody of the passengers. It is also known as carry-on baggage. It includes items like purse, laptop, and it contains other special items, but information of that has to be given in advance, such as pets or holy human remains in urns. Prior to carriage of cabin baggage, assessment of the size, common number and weight of items should be done as per the air operator standards. Also, the weight aspect with regard to the cabin baggage should be checked in case the carry-on baggage exceeds the free allowance weight or size, then it should be hold, checked and charged accordingly. A traveler prior to boarding of an aircraft should be well aware about the dangerous food and the other items and be honest enough to convey it to the airline operator. Usually, all types of baggage including the cabin baggage is a handover to airline handling agent at check-in counter, and thereafter passengers receive the boarding pass prior to boarding of an aircraft. If the cabin baggage do not meet the cabin standards, then in that case it can be accommodated in the checked baggage. As told earlier, all types of baggage including the checked baggage is collected at the check-in area of the airport. The traveler is permitted to carry on luggage with him, her in the cabin. The size or dimensions of the hand baggage in India should be equal to 115 cm for Boeing and Airbus, totaling the dimensions in case of international sectors, and 110 cm for domestic sectors. The maximum weight omitted for hand baggages is 8 kg for passengers. When a newborn infant or infant, if he is traveling in the aircraft, then the adult accompanying him can carry a carry cot or fully collapsible stroller. Apart from the above hand baggage allowances, one of the following items of baggage is also allowed, such as ladies' handbag, overcoat, camera or binocular, reasonable amount of reading material for the flight, infants, feet, collapsible wheelchair. Also, the infant or toddler is not given seat or free baggage allowance, though the adult accompanying the child can carry a carry cot or a collapsible stroller in cabin space if available or in checked baggage. An abnormal size luggage will not be allowed in the cabin. Though apart from one piece of cabin baggage, the travelers will not be allowed to carry liquids, gels or aerosols such as toothpaste, cream lotions, hair gels, sprays, liquid, cosmetics, etc. Due to security reasons, travelers going to some cities such as Jammu, Srinagar in JNK are not allowed to carry any hand baggage. Also, the Sikh travelers are allowed to carry kripan but not exceeding 9 inches within India. The power banks can be carried in the hand baggage, however, lithium battery driven devices are prohibited. Now I will discuss about checked baggage. The checked baggage is the baggage which the air carrier take into his custody and issues a baggage check, and then this baggage goes for storage in the hold of the aircraft. The air operator has full right to refuse the check-in baggage if it is improperly or inadequately packed for air carriage on the ground of weight, size and nature. Every baggage on the aircraft should display its name with the baggage tag. All the passengers travelling in aircraft are entitled to a predetermined checked baggage allowance which is fixed by the air operator. In case of checked baggage allowance, two concepts are used: the weight concept, which measures the total weight of checked baggage and whose limit is laid down depending upon the category of cabin class. In some airlines, the piece concept is also used, and measure of the number of the checked baggage is done. In case the checked baggage exceeds the weight of piece concept, in that case excess baggage per kg or number is charged. In domestic airlines within India, the child baggage allowance varies from first class to economy class. It is 40 kg in case of first class, 35 kg in case of business class, 25 kg in case of economy class, and in certain cases 10 kg is also given to infants classes. The passenger handovers the checked baggage in the check-in area to the airport staff. First of all, the air staff checks for the security sticker and condition of the baggage and makes sure that the baggage has been screened properly and do not contain any dangerous articles. If the baggage exceeds the free baggage allowance, extra money or allowance is recharged on the basis of weight of item or dimensions, and a baggage tag is attached to the baggage. All the registered or check-in baggage is segregated in the baggage makeup area, that is BMA, reconciled by the airline employee, consolidated in trolleys, and then dispatched to the region of aircraft movement and parking, that is ramp. In the BMA area, the airline employee has to remain vigilant so that no pilferage occurs. The various functions of baggage makeup area include the segregation of the checked baggage and consolidated in the trolleys according to the type of baggage. All the tags such as security tags and passenger baggage tag are also checked. Now I will discuss about special baggage. Special baggage includes the bulky and oversized baggage, cabin seat baggage, crew baggage, sporting equipment, wheelchairs and mobility aids, pets, etc. All the special baggage items should have baggage tag specifying the type of the luggage or baggage. Also, the ULD in which the special baggage is to be stored over, it has to be seen whether it is in good condition. Once the check-in stops, the baggage supervisor reviews the total number of pieces for each ULD, that is unit load device. Thereafter, the checked baggage is removed, which has the name, former security number and an electronic record to locate a ULD. In some countries, high standards of baggage screening are adopted and special luggage is removed in a phased manner, depending on the category of the special baggage. Now I will discuss about baggage security. For baggage security, IATA has issued strict instructions in IATA Security Manual and Operating Airline Ground Operations Manuals. Whether it is the passengers or the cabin crew, they will have to get their hold baggage identified prior to loading. And there should be no chance for the interchanging cabin baggage for hold baggage which may have items which may be used in illegal ways. If the weapons are being carried, they have to be kept in secured locations. The items removed by security personnel during security screening are also accepted for hold luggage. When the baggage have been collected from the hold baggage during transfer process, it should be considered as originating baggage. But if the baggage is collected and transferred in sterile area, then rescreening is not important. Reconciliation of passenger or baggage maintained for all flights, that is for standby travelers, check-in of passengers in group or of airport, or in case of voluntary or involuntary deplaning. In case of online and transfer passengers, the checked baggage comes under the additional security controls. In case of interline passengers, baggage of non-confirmed passengers should not be loaded as hold baggage. In case of disembarking travelers, the baggage both checked and cabin should be offloaded prior to his station of arrival. After receipt of checked baggage, it is kept in a safe area and the cabin baggage individually identified and marked as crew. The norms for dangerous goods carriage should refer to the IATA Dangerous Goods Regulations DGR. Now I will discuss about the mishandled baggage. In case of mishandled or unclaimed or unidentified baggage, its details should be entered into the tracing system, which is kept in a safe area and should be subjected to additional security controls before being loaded in the airline craft such as manual search, simulation chamber, X-ray, vapor or trace analysis. Also for it, the rush tag should be used and the unaccompanied baggage kept in the aft bulk hold of the aircraft. The mobility aids which have been delayed, damaged or missing, handled on the priority basis and instantaneously arranged for its replacement. Now I would summarize the entire module. Whenever we are planning for new passenger terminals, it is exceptionally vital to design a baggage handling system BHS that will necessarily meet the requirements of a terminal and its passengers. A baggage handling system primarily consists of various areas that aid various roles, comprising inputs of baggage, screening area, makeup area, and claim area. All the volume of the passenger categories decide the type and size of baggage handling system and the various phases required for their planning. The outbound baggage have 5 types of inputs, that is staffed check-in counters, self-service check-in kiosks, bag drop counters, self-tagging stations, curbside check-in. Baggage sortation systems are used in the sorting of the baggage and luggage. The baggage broadly comes in 3 categories, that is cabin baggage, checked baggage and special baggage. For baggage security, IATA has issued strict instructions in IATA Security Manual and Operating Airline Ground Operations Manual. Whether it is the passengers or the cabin crew, they will have to get their hold baggage identified prior to loading. The norms for dangerous goods carriage should refer to the IATA Dangerous Goods Regulations DGR. In case of mishandled or unclaimed baggage, its detail should be entered into the tracing system. It should be kept in a safe area and should be subjected to additional security controls. At the end, I would like to say is that the management of baggage systems and procedures is a step prior to boarding of the aircraft, but importance lies in how effectively we manage it. Thank you and have a great future.